This is Dan Owen, and this is a frozen passage attack. The snow's all over the ground. So I want you to turn your Bibles to Hebrews chapter 11, verses 8 through 16. In this passage, we're talking about faithfulness as acting on the promises of God. The background of this passage goes back to chapter 10, verse 36, where the writer says, "You have need of endurance, so that having done the will of God, you may inherit what was promised. For in yet a little while, he that is coming will come and will not delay, and my righteous one will live by faithfulness. But if he shrinks back, my soul has no pleasure in him. For we are not of them that shrink back unto punishment, but of them that are faithful unto the saving of our soul." So in that passage, the stage is set for chapter 11, where he talks about faithfulness as people that endure doing the will of God and trust all the while in the promises of God. So let's look at our passage together and think about those elements. Notice in verse 8, by faith or by faithfulness, Abraham, when he was called, obeyed by going out. It's very important to note that he was going to a place which he was to receive for an inheritance. Now in Genesis 15, God promised Abraham that the land that he was lying on, which was not his land, would one day, 400 some odd years in the future, belong to his people. It would be an inheritance. So, trusting in that promise of God, verse 8 says he went out, not knowing even where he was going. This is when he left Ur of the Chaldees, and then he went up to Syria, and he left Syria, and he came into the land of promise. All right? By faith, verse 9, or by faithfulness, he, that's Abraham, lived as an alien in the land of promise. Now, when he came to the land of Canaan, in Genesis 15, he was living as a stranger. It was not his land. He did not have control of that land. It was controlled by others, but he was willing to live in that land as an alien because he was trusting in the promise of God. Notice he says again, he was living as in a foreign land, dwelling in tents. He was a stranger, he was a sojourner, but God promised him that one day that land would be his, along with Isaac and Jacob, fellow heirs of the same promise. See, God made the promise in Genesis 15 that he would give him that land, and he was trusting in that promise. But Abraham was even looking beyond the land. He went out from Ur. He came to the promised land. It still was not his land, but he was trusting that someday, maybe long after he was gone, it would be the land of his people. But it tells us here that Abraham was looking for a city which has foundations, whose architect and maker is God. Abraham lived in the world as an alien. He was gonna go wherever God wanted him to go because he was looking for an eternal city. Notice the same concept of faithfulness in the promise of God with Sarah. By faith or faithfulness, even Sarah herself received the ability to conceive, even beyond the proper time of life. Notice this little part right here. Since she considered him faithful who had promised. It was based on the promise of God that was made to her in Genesis 18, when at first she even laughed, that she went ahead and conceived this child, trusting that God would do what God promised. So what is faithfulness? Faithfulness is looking beyond what you can see and trusting so much in the promises of God that you're willing to act on those promises and live based on those promises. In verse 13, talking about Abraham and Sarah and all these others, it says, these all died in faith. Now, this is a very interesting phrase, especially in the original language. It could actually be translated, these all died in a faithful manner. The way they died was doing the will of God. But notice they died without receiving the promises. Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, Sarah. They never saw the reality of those great far-reaching promises in Genesis 15 and Genesis 17 about receiving the inheritance of the land of promise. But, it says, they died in faithfulness, it says, having seen them. And see, they saw them through the eye of faith, those promises. They didn't see the reality of them, but they saw them through the eye of faith. And they welcomed those promises, see, from a distance. They were out in the future, but they still welcomed them. And this is because they had confessed in their own hearts, in their own minds, that they were strangers and exiles on the earth. Now remember, it tells us that when Abraham went to the land of promise, he lived as a stranger. He lived as an exile. But beyond just living as a stranger or as an exile into the land of Canaan, he actually believed that he was a stranger and an alien in the earth. For those who say such things, this refers, excuse me, let me change colors there. This refers to people like Abraham, people like Isaac and Jacob, people who, according to verse 13, received the promises of God, and they greeted them from afar, and they confessed that they were strangers and pilgrims in the earth. Those who say such things make it clear that they are seeking a country of their own. This word for country is a word which means your hometown or your homeland, your own native land. But they did not feel that the world was their home. They did not feel like anywhere. When Abraham left Ur, Ur was not his home. When Abraham went to Canaan, Canaan was not his home. His home was wherever God wanted him to go eventually. And it says, indeed, if you look at this paragraph in verse 15, if they had been thinking of the country from which they went out, they would have had opportunity to return. See, God kept them moving forward. God moved Abraham from Ur to the land of Canaan. Abraham wasn't looking back at the land of Ur. He was going forward to meet the promises of God. When Isaac and Jacob, when Jacob and Joseph had to leave the land of Canaan and go to Egypt, they weren't looking backward. They were looking forward, trusting still in the promises of God. So such people who live in faithfulness, who desire to follow God into their eternity, it says they desire a better country that is a heavenly one. And therefore, see, that's because they'll follow God wherever God wants them to go. God is not ashamed to be called their God, for he has prepared for them a city. Now, for Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, God prepared for their descendants a land, the land of Canaan. But even so, even when they didn't inherit it in their lifetime, they trusted and lived by faithfulness, trusting in that promise. God has prepared for us a city. And if we in our lifetime will do the will of God and follow him through his word wherever he wants us to go, then we will inherit that which was promised. Going back to the original idea in chapter 10, verse 36, you have need of endurance so that having done the will of God, you will inherit what has been promised. I'm Dan Owen. This is Passage Attack. I hope you have a good cold week. Stay warm. We'll see you soon.